Today I'll be teaching us how to do a k-means cluster. The data is on the screen where I've got five variables: age, occupation, education, income and standard of living. So to do the test, move on to analyze, scroll down to classify, from there move on to k-means cluster. Select all the variables in one go with the help of shift key and place it in the variables. The number of clusters, put it as 4. In the earlier video I taught you as to how to find the number of clusters with the help of dendrogram method and agglomerative method. The number of clusters suggested is 4. In the case of iterate, let it be as default. In the case of save, click cluster membership and click continue. The case of options, click ANOVA table, cluster information for each case and click continue. Let everything be as default and click OK. The results appear on the screen. The first 3 is not required for reporting. There is initial cluster, iteration history and cluster membership. So the one which is required is the final cluster center, ANOVA, as well as the number of cases in each cluster. So in cluster 1 there are about 9 respondents, 2 there are 9 respondents, 3, 5, 4, 2 respondents. So the total number of respondents is 25 and there's no missing case. So I've already typed the result in a Word format. We can keep as such and just go through it. In the case of ANOVA, you should not report the sig value. You have to report only the f value. So this, which has already been written over here. In ANOVA, only the f value should be taken into consideration, not the sig value. So here the income has a greater influence in deciding the cluster, since the F value is 147.374. The next variable is standard of living, that is 8.120. The next is occupation, that is 1.606, age 1.011. And the least important factor to influence a cluster is education with 0.608. So next we are moving on to the cluster, the final cluster. Just scroll it up. So in cluster 1, on an average, the income of the respondents is, say, 31,000, age is 37 years, occupation is, say, a service, because I have given a dummy of 3 for service, and education level is UG, since I have given a dummy of 2 for UG, and the standard of living is low, because those under 35,000 earning rupees 35,000 and below are coming under the first category, and above 35,000 comes under the second category. So here the standard of living is low. Similarly, explain for cluster 2, 3 and 4. So this I have already discussed. In cluster 1 there are about 9 respondents. To explain all these clusters easily, you can explain it with the help of a bar diagram. But in this analysis, it becomes difficult to explain it with the help of cluster, because the income is of a higher value when compared to the rest of the variables. So the rest of the variables will never appear, but still I will show you as to how to create a graph. Give a double click over here and select all the values with the help of left tab, and with the help of right tab, go to create graph and go to bar. So since income is of higher value, only that is represented, the rest goes unnoticed. So this is how you have to interpret your results in your thesis or dissertation or project. The next one, we are going towards the data sheet. In the data sheet, you can see the number 1, 2, 3. So the first respondent belongs to the first cluster, the second one belongs to the second cluster, the third respondent belongs to the third cluster, the sixth respondent belongs to the fourth cluster. So with this value, you can do your ANOVA, you can do your multiple discriminant analysis with the help of this cluster membership. Thank you for listening.